So class, we'll begin or we'll continue with this chapter, electromagnetism. Earlier I have sent you these the videos from YouTube. Now I'll teach with these recorded videos, and first of all we'll begin with this again, Oersted's experiment on the magnetic effect of electric current. Basically, Hans Oersted was the scientist who discovered that whenever there is electric current i, then because of that current a magnetic field is produced. Magnetic field is shown by the symbol B. Okay, whenever there is current, that current will produce a magnetic field around it. But when will this current produce magnetic field? When this current is moving. Okay, so moving current or moving charges produce a magnetic field around it. So there is an experiment to demonstrate it. So here you can see a battery is there, then this conducting wire is there, and below this conductor or below this wire is the compass needle, then a key, a rheostat. Okay, a rheostat is used to vary the resistance or to change the resistance anytime. Then key here is open. In the second case you can see everything else is same except the key and the needle. What happens when the key is closed? The current starts flowing in this circuit. The current will flow from positive terminal to negative terminal. And as I have told you that whenever the current will flow, it will produce magnetic field. So because of this magnetic field that is produced, this compass needle is showing the deflection. It is tilted. Earlier it was straight and now it is tilted. Clear? Then third case you see. In the third case, the direction of current is reversed. Earlier it was flowing from A to B end. Okay. Now it will flow from B to A end. Here the direction of current is reversed. You must clearly understand that whenever the direction of current is reversed, the direction of deflection of needle will also reverse, because the direction of magnetic field lines will reverse. Clear? Earlier it was deflecting this way and now it is deflecting this way. Then here you can see in the fourth case. In these two cases, the compass needle was capped below the wire, and now in this fourth case and fifth case, the compass needle is capped above the wire. So the same case you can see. Suppose if the current is flowing from A to B end, okay, the needle is deflecting this way. Okay, now if the direction of current is reversed, if the current will flow from B to A end, then the needle will deflect this way. Clear? Basically what you must remember, that if the direction of current is reversed, the direction of deflection of needle will reverse, and if the needle is capped above or below the wire, that conditions will also affect the deflection of the needle or the compass.